I seek refuge to Allah from the rejected Lucifer. In the name of Allah, God most gracious, most merciful. Today is Wednesday, 16 January 2019. Episode number 445, under the title of "In Order to Be Preponderate, You Have to Drudge." Okay, my dear brothers and sisters, my viewers, my beloved viewers, how beautiful this day is to talk to you back again. And I cannot describe the thrill and rejoice that I am in, since I am talking and interacting with you through this part of the media in this part of the world. Well, there is nothing will come to you unless you do something. And this is the skill. The more you give, the more you get. The more you strive, the more you prefer. Well, this is the God made this world acting that way. This is the system and principle of the Almighty God. He created this universe in this such a manner. And without this, it won't work, it won't act. If you try to act according to something other than this, it won't work. It won't work. It won't work in the right manner. Now, people, some of them, is sitting and waiting for the unseen thing to happen to them, for the miracles. Okay, I talked to somebody. Why didn't you do this and this? And says, God will fix it somehow. I didn't know it. Well, my brother, God won't do this, except sometimes for exceptional things. But normal way, it won't work. And in this way, you don't take the big rock from your way in order to prevail, in order to succeed and to achieve your goal. And this is because of the something from the teaching of the religions, because there's part of the religions they said, okay, this will act according to if you supplicate to God and the miracle will appear to you and will be this and that. Well, sometimes it works, but sometimes it didn't. The normal way God made it is to do something. God says, work, and Allah will give you a record for that work. Didn't see you sleep, says work, says learn. You know the first verse from the Quran to reveal, to have been revealed to the Holy Prophet Muhammad, maybe the blessing, increasing blessing upon him and his companions and his followers. It does say, read. It doesn't say, be witness, there's no God but God and the last messenger of God is Muhammad. It doesn't say that. It didn't say prostrate in prayer and supplicate to God. It didn't say that. It does say, learn. Read means learn, seek the cognition. Wherever you find it, run after it until you grab it. And when you grab it, you snatch it. You took it. And when you took it, you swallow it. You put it part of your shoes, your body issue. Let it be part of your daily life. When you woke up, then you supplicate and you go to prayer, of course, either you're a Muslim or a Christian, whatever you are. Then after that, you took the breakfast, I believe. After that, get to read. It's something. Learn something, man. Get the graph from for your age graph and your knowledge graph got to be matched together. And the more your knowledge graph will be higher than your age graph, you will be succeed enough. Keep, don't drag yourself behind the scene and not doing the right thing. Don't do it. Nothing from nothing leaves nothing. I'm gonna see some verse from the Holy Quran, and it says, God created us in toil and in struggle, and we have to struggle in this life till the day we meet God. We are in a struggling way. That's the longer trend. We have to overcome so many obstacles in our way. And the more you struggle, the more you suffer, the more the life would become lovely and tasty. The more you rejoice. Well, that's the way God created, man. And it's very lovely. I'm sure most of you guys, my friends, have traveled, taste this, and you have been through this, either intentionally or unintentionally. And when you struggle, you suffer, you strive, you become very tired, and then you relax, and the good result come to you, and you rejoice, you'll be happy, you'll be happy and thrilled. You will be a furious person, I can say this. You feel you are very active, very happy after the struggle. You know, exercising, if you are a boxing man, you have to go through some difficulties. Somebody will punch you in the jaw. You got to learn, you know, I met the late Muhammad Ali, maybe the blessing in being the mercy of God being. I met him and I saw his left hand like the camel sitting hand. You know, it's very, very rough. Left hand. He's left-handed, by the way. The late Muhammad Ali, he's left-handed. And, you know, the story of the late Muhammad Ali, it's a long, you know, I think we did talk about it. We talked about it, I think, before. And the heroes of the world, there is no hero come out to be hero unless he went and he's unless he already went through some difficulties and exams. And he prevail and he succeed. So, without struggle, you cannot. There is no way for you to be preponderate. There is no way to be a preponderant person. You have to struggle. You have to drudge. You have to drudge. Without this, just forget it. As we said, in the title of this session, this episode, it says as it is. In order to be preponderant, you have to drudge. That's the only way. My dear brother and sister, I'm talking to you especially in my talk, especially to the youths all over the world, because to be in that age as a youth, you are very active and you can do lots of things, not like people in the age of 70 or 60 or 100, whatever. It's not like that. So being in youth, being active, and if you lose your youth time as a teenager or as a youth, you lose a lot of your life, because in your youth time you can, in one day you can do like if you are an age of 70 or 80, 1 month for example. You know, if you get old, you cannot move that much, you cannot wake up that much, you know, your body become very weak in order to go to die. You cannot die unless you are weak. Have you seen somebody died unless he is weak? You get to be weak first, either you have an anchor, an accident, or you been through some sickness, you'll be weak. So, use and don't lose your youth time. It's the best, it's a golden age of yours. It's a precious, unless it's a precious time for you. This is the precious time for you. You got to learn lots of things. Knowledge, boxing, flying, be mechanic, anything. Know the Quran, know how to run, how to fight, how to go deep in the sea with the fishes. You know, if you go to the shark, you learn how to shark something. It might bite you, but you've got to be there. In order to study the shark, well, there's the shark might attack you. You know, especially if he's angry. How can you study the shark without getting close to the shark? Well, you have to have some provisions to prevent you from the shark bite. You know the shark, you know how the teeth of the shark, it is going opposite. It is two rows actually going in the opposite side in order to kill people and to take them. So you got to go to where the difficulties is in order to study it, in order to overcome it. You cannot stay away from where the struggle places and you want to do something, to succeed in something. No. Cannot. That's not the way. Well, I'm sure all of us, you guys, see this thing daily. If you are going outside or if you are listening to the media, this is the struggle. This is the life. You have to struggle daily. Don't sleep unless you need this to sleep in night time. Other than that, don't do it. I'm talking to everybody. Either he is an old person, or he's a teenager, either he is Eskimo, or American, or Mexican, or Russian, or anybody, or even Arabs. You have to study. You have to work. You have to do something. Don't be the last one in the marathon, and don't be the black sheep too. Well, watch out not to be black sheep, attacked by people. Don't do that. Don't do something for people bad. It will be in your account as a negative thing to have it in your file. Either in this day, in this life, or the hereafter, in the judgment day, you'll find that black spot in your file to try to eliminate it, erase it by good deed. And the Quran does say that the good deed eliminate and erase the bad deed. If you sin, I'm sure all of us are sinning. We are sinners, people. Adam and Eve sin, and we are going to sin. Well, by the way, there's so many items, Adam and Eve. There's so many, we came through evolution, an evolution. It's not contradicting the Quran. No. Well, this Quran says God created us in stages, evoluted. Okay, we come baby, we come old man, and so it's a go through so many processes. And the Quran does say that in verses in it. So, I think I have to conclude and finish this by saying, oh guys, nothing will come to you if you are sitting in the back of your seat, car, without doing something. If you sit in the back of the car, the seat of the car, and say, I'm going to drive the car. You'll be lunatic. You need to see the psychiatric doctor. Because you'll be mad, you'll be crazy. How can you want to drive the car, this car, which they made to be driven from the front seat to the right or to the left? You want to drive it from back in the back seat of the car? Unless you have car by remote control. But this kind of car we have in it, in our time, day and time, the normal cars, you got to be in the right seat or the left seat to, in order to drive that car. How can you press the button of the clutch if you have standard, and with the gear shift, lever and number one tunes and so on, and the accelerator? Please, you cannot do something unless you go to the procedure for that something to be done. Then that you are actually catching the air, if I can say this. You can talk a lot about this subject. It will take hours and hours to talk about it. But I'm gonna stop here. And by saying to you this, I want to emphasize in this, please, and I appeal to you, whenever we made mistakes, what must we do? We must listen to the other people who are advising us and correcting us. And when he corrects us, please, no hesitation to come back to the truth, come back to the straight path. Because if you delay it, maybe you will tumble and you get out of the road and you hurt yourself. You might get killed. So, I want to emphasize and to make affirming this, that whenever I made mistakes and somebody came to me and tell me that mistake with the proof, I will come back very easy. And I will try not to do this again. I will try to be away from it. We are sending this message by telling you guys, peace be unto you, peace. Peace, tranquility. You have to be a tranquilized person. Get the tranquility, the happiness, the rejoice, the calmness. You can be calm, calm. If you have the right thing, you didn't bother people, you'll be calm. If you bother people, you're no calm. You cannot calm. You'll be nervous. You will be regret. You blame yourself. Yourself will blame you. Keep blaming you. Keep knocking you. So, until I see you later, by the God will and help, peace be unto you all.